Let's start by sitting quietly and see what's here. What you are bringing here, right now. So, in whatever way, see if you can welcome or sense what's here, whatever arises. See if you can invite or connect, sense, especially your intense feeling. This is a first step into your practice. We dive into a channel ground. So your body is a good tool to sense feeling, this felt sense of whatever arises. What is it? Before we get started, see if you can articulate a little bit. What's your feeling? Despair, a sense of uncertainty, fear, or a sense of numbing out or escaping. What is it? See if you can quietly connect part of you. So another way or one way to do that, maybe sense that this field, horizontal field, like you sitting here right now, right? With this body, mind. Then in Buddhism, we talk about the ocean of samsara, ocean of suffering. See if you can sense that, this horizontal field that connect you through human conditions, pure external dilemma, as your internal, your own dilemma. This human violence, cruelty, whatever might be. Can you sense it? Can you feel it? In your practice, we need that extreme sense or extreme feeling without bypassing or pushing away. Rather, we use that. So we want to stay open, aware. So we are not here to shut out or shut down or retreat away from what's happening, but we are here to practice so that we can feel more and we become capable of participating so that we can feel more what's happening for others. Experience a felt sense of experience of others. When we allow the body to become more sensitive this way and throughout this ritual, your ritual, that's how it works. It's not about numbing out, spacing out, or bypassing. So I think, I believe that's partially why we are here. As well as connecting a sense of internal resilience, strength, grounding we need right now to have for apparently needed for long-term stamina to work for others. Then I think today's intention or maybe prayer. See if you can allow the prayers. May today's practice help me to become a, whatever way, what you want to become, what you want to be. Perhaps a servant of humanity. May I able to see what is beautiful, wise, innately knows in life, nature, and each other. May our practice help us to keep our intention in our prayers. So now I want you to breathe in all part of the body. Invite your breath awareness into your body, your psyche, on behalf of community, human communities, sentient beings. Then let's allow that breath and awareness, along with that prayer you just made, permeate or fill your entire body. Send your message, prayer, throughout the internal body. And lengthen up the spine. Lift the base of the skull and even collarbone. Cross to the heart. Heart lifted, sternum lifted. And relax your eyes, ears, jaws, shoulders, all these other parts, limbs, as if draping down like a curtain. Relax your solar plexus as well. So this vertical line, I want you to connect that now. As you connect it to this horizontal field in which difficulty has been played out, human condition has been played out, then I want you to connect this vertical line, divine line, I call, line up with divine nature, your true nature, who and what you truly are. So now silently, quietly connect this silent, quiet stream of presence within that infuses you. It's way larger than what you think you are. So we're going to travel today horizontally as well as vertically. We connect to the divine within. Again, you come back to this awareness of the plane, horizontal field of humanity, human condition, which entail the interconnectedness. See if your heart is a little more open. See if your heart can feel more, but without the despair. And also I want you to connect to this vertical line of your true nature, connection to the divine, which might have given you a little more strength, courage, fearlessness,